Hello and welcome to another episode of Match Day Live here at Somerset Park as Portadown welcome Carrick Rangers in the penultimate home game here at Somerset Park. My name is Mark Beattie.
Hello, and I'm Johnny. As Mark says, welcome along here to Somerset Park for today's Danske Bank Premiership game against Carrick Rangers. The game, as always, will be streamed live via We Are Ports TV Live, and that is able to be purchased at a price of £7 via 247.tv/NIPrem. You forgot myself there for a minute.
I say penultimate, which is a really big word.
I think that's
really
what's through me.
Listen, if you can take me a second here, and if you can go down to our YouTube page and give us a like and subscribe to the page, just so you can be notified of all our upcoming videos, all the content will be there. So the more subscribers we have, the better our content can be and the page can grow. So if you can do that for us, we'd be very appreciative. We'll just cut straight into it. We've got the teams here for this afternoon's game. If we can fire them up on the screen, do you want to go with the home team, Johnny?
Yeah, I'll go with the Portadown team. Now, there's two changes to the Portadown team from Tuesday past's defeat to Glenavon. Out have went Eamon Scannell and Ben Guy, and in come Stephen Taggart and Sam Ward. So the Portadown team then, I think if Matt is going to put it up on the screen then, is Jacob Carney in nets, then the defence of Greg Hall, Adam McCallum, Paul Finnegan and Nathan Kerr. Then we have George Tipton, Stephen Taggart, Sam Ward and Ben Tilney with Lee Bonus and Adam Sally up front.
Yeah, the visitors then, Carrick Rangers, they're unchanged from their Irish Cup exit against Larne last week, as they have Aaron Hogg and Nets. The last time they were here, I think the last few times we played them, they played with a back three, but it looks like they're going to set up with a back four this afternoon with Curtis Forsyth, Neil as the fullbacks, and Lochran and I'm going to say Stephen Gordon in the middle. Midfield wise, of Lee Chapman, Kyle Cherry, Reece Glendinning, and Lloyd Anderson, and then up top, maybe Michael Smith up top, and then Jordan Gibson and just behind him. So the visitors are unchanged then from their exit with Larne. They'll be disappointed, obviously, going out in the Irish Cup, as were we with Ballymena.
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, I sort of read reports about the game. I think Carrick pushed Larne, but as I say, Larne progressed. Matthew, and from a Portadown perspective, I was sort of saying to you during the week, Matthew, you talked about the cup this year, and you know, with lesser teams in it, you know, there was a pathway for a team like ourselves to do well. You look at Ballymena, you know, since Ballymena beat us, then I think they played Dirkview, and then PSNA and Dirkview, and now find themselves in an Irish Cup semi final. So, no, but as you say, I'm sure Carrick Rangers will be disappointed at that cup exit.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it was with both teams where the league was going, there's no relegation on that, so there's not a whole lot to play for down the bottom of the league. The Irish Cup was the only thing to play for. That's all the sites were on. So both sides were disappointed to go out. Probably, if we're going to be honest, probably went out against better, against two better sides in Larne and Ballymena.
Yeah.
I think over the course of the season they proved that they're a better side than both Portadown and Carrick. So there were no surprises.
No.
But I think both sides were looking to be the upset in that round of the Cup. So they'll be disappointed. Let's talk about today's game then. So after last night's result, 1 point were beaten by Glenavon. Portadown have a chance then to potentially gain 3 points and move back up the ninth.
Yeah, I think we've said this here the last couple of weeks. At the start of the season, the aim here at Shamrock Park was to finish 10th. You didn't want to, even though there was no relegation, and you know Matthew has hammered at home that didn't matter a jot. You wanted still to, you didn't want to finish in those bottom two places to have that stigma over you for next season. As in, well, if there'd been a normal season, we'd have went down. So to be in with a shout of finishing 9th, it's a great card to be dangling in front of these players. So you know, 3 points today sends you up to 9th. So, you know, I feel, you know, that's something to play for the team for these last three games of the season.
Yeah, it's definitely something. It's maybe not a whole lot, but yeah. Potentially they're playing for more than that. They're playing for they're playing for next season. They're playing for the chance to get a contract. Some players have secured the contract, like Paul Finnegan, have secured their future here. But there's other guys in that team and on the bench that'll be looking to make to prove their point that they're worth a contract. Maybe not even Porto now, maybe somebody else in this league. So they'll be out to impress. They'll be out to do what they can to secure the future, really.
Yeah, you're right. You know, like you say, I think Paul Finnegan's tied down for next season. But you know, Lee Bonus, and Luke Wilson as well. Obviously, have said a long-term contract. But for every other player, Portadown player out there, they're playing for their futures. Playing to, if they want to stay at Portadown, or you say if they want to move on to other things, they're playing to put themselves in the shop window as well. So from a player perspective, you know, you're quite right in saying there's a lot to play for this season. Just on today's match, you know, we're coming off the back, it seems like a lifetime ago, because we're used to Saturday, Tuesday, but that really disappointing defeat away to Glenavon, where, you know, Matthew was quite scathing in his criticism of the team that evening, and I think we would agree, rightly so. It was a very disappointing performance, especially for a derby. So I'm hoping to see a big response here from these players today, to put that defeat right and get themselves back on track.
Yeah, like you say, that derby defeat was hard to take. I don't want to talk about it too much, but I think I have to. It was almost I walked away. I was disappointed. Everybody else was disappointed and all that. But and I was angry at certain players that almost gave up.
Yeah.
And that's what I hate to see. I hate to see players give up when there's still time to play. But the one thing I was comparing it to was the time we beat Glenavon here 4-1. It was almost a carbon copy. That match could have been any result to Portadown. It could have been 8 or 9.
Mm-hmm.
You know, towards the end, the Portadown were cutting Glenavon open like a hot knife through butter. But it was a complete opposite. It really could have been more for Glenavon. The only thing that stopped them was Jacob Carney was fantastic.
Yeah, Jacob and possibly Lee were probably the only two players that come out of that game. You know, with a bit of credit, Jacob especially in the first half, he pulled save after save after save, and he did probably prevent it from being 6, 7, 8. And like you'd said to me at the time, and I hadn't really thought about it that much, but that time we beat Glenavon here 4-1, you know, I think we hit the bar 2 or 3 times as well, maybe missed a couple of one-on-ones and well. So you know, the two games were a carbon copy of each other's, where it could have ended up and he scores 7, 8, 9 to the home team.
Yep, and at the end of the day, we won the year on aggregate.
So I'm happy enough.
Let's put that to bed.
And away goals as well. That's the main thing.
Let's put that to bed. So we'll have a wee break here for a few minutes. We'll have Matthew Tipton coming up as well to have a wee chat with us pre-match. And we'll have a wee chat again about the Saturday's game. Hello and welcome back to Massey Live here at Shamrock Park. Both sets of players are out warming up. I was going to say it's a sunny day at Shamrock Park, but it's sunny 1 minute, it's raining the next. You just don't know what the weather's going to be like.
I know. It's bright anyway, rain at the moment.
Yep, hopefully it stays that way. We'll talk about today's game then. So Port Down Carrick, we've had a bit of a storied history over the last few years with Carrick. The battles have always been close. When they're in the same league, we're always right beside each other. So they're always big games for both teams. The truth is, probably getting the season, especially away from home, Carrick had our underpants down for most of it, really, you know. So going away to the Taylor's Avenue, I call it, but going away there, we've struggled, but when we brought them here to Shamrock Park, we beat them 2-0 recently with two good goals. So
our record here at Shamrock Park is pretty decent against Carrick. I think it's maybe only one defeat in the last 11 or 12. It might even be longer than that. We've had our problems with Carrick at Taylor's Avenue, like we say. We've took some heavy defeats up there the past couple of games, and some major disappointments up there as well in the championship. Over these recent seasons, you know, since our relegation and in the championship games, you know, with the two have sort of been nip and tuck in around the league standings and all, and you know, there hasn't been much between the teams in regards to where they finished in the respective leagues. But you know, we're coming into this game on the back of a victory against Carrick here, so hopefully that home form against Carrick continues today.
Yeah, looking at the team, so I'll say there before we're talking about the lineups, Carrick usually come with a back three, three big centre halves, and with a bit of pace down the full backs down the side. They've changed today. It looks like it's going to be a 4-4-2. Now, I could change with the line up, but personnel wise, it looks like it's going to be a 4-4-2 with Gordon and Lochran in the middle. So something a bit more what the Portadown players will be accustomed to. They're used to playing against four defenders. The three defenders maybe isn't as used to. So it's a change from what we normally see Carrick. Their midfield are going to be interesting. So I always rate Lloyd Anderson. The last time I gave him a really big build up here at Shamrock, he didn't really play well that day, but any time we played them up at Carrick, he's always impressed me with his energy, with his quality on the ball. So he's going to be one player that we're going to have to look after as well.
You know what, it was sort of going to be sound like we're going to be repeating ourselves again here today, but you know, as we've spoken about, Carrick are a physical team, and they like to draw teams into that trap. You know, they have Caelan Lochran there, they have the likes of Michael Smith and all. You know, they've good players there that have hurt us in the past, especially Caelan Lochran. But you know, in past meetings we have sometimes got drawn into traps by the likes of Lochran and things like that, and we seem to have learned our lesson from the last game here. We didn't get drawn into that trap. We played our own game, you know, and it was a convincing 2-0 victory on the day. Although I think we left it late until Lee secured the win that Saturday. So no, as long as we stick to our own game, play our own game plan, and don't get drawn into physicality of what Carrick can sometimes try and get teams drawn into, we should be okay.
When you mention physicality, the one thing I always thought that we made the mistake of doing at the beginning of the season up at Taylor's Avenue, we tried to play the same game as Carrick. We tried to get physical with them, we tried to almost wrestle with them during the match. And Carrick are bigger, they're stronger, they're going to win that battle. Whereas when we beat them here at Shamrock, we were the team playing the football. We were playing out from the back, we were having some nice passes to players and stuff. So I think that's what the blueprint for us to do again. We need to play that football and hope that we can get around Carrick rather than try to muscle through them, try to go around them.
Yeah, and we also have the benefit of coming into this game off a 10-day break. It hasn't been often since Christmas where we've been able to, you know, to say that, where, you know, it's been Saturday, Tuesday. Lorne haven't had that break. You know, they had the Irish Cup game against Lorne on Tuesday night and would have been giving it their all. So hopefully Portadown can use that bit of break and that rest to their advantage.
Yeah, if you're watching the stream here live, if you can, in the wee comments section down below on Facebook and YouTube, if you can give us your predictions for today's game, give us your predictions and your goal scores, just for a wee bit of interest as well. If you want a bit of help with that, I've been doing a bit of stats, and this is probably your end of the bargain, but I was sitting at home this morning doing this, and Carrick have conceded the most in the league this year with 81. Averaging out at 2.3 per game. Don't know what that means, but whatever. And scoring only 30 and 35, averaging at 0.86 per game. So that means we're going to win 2-1, is it?
I think so. And you look at you were talking there, they've scored, 30 goals there? But nine of those have been against us, haven't they?
That would be right, So they enjoy playing against us, honestly. And then I was going to say, even a lot of them are from Caelan Lochran himself.
Yeah.
I think he's a top scorer, 7 or 8.
I think they might be, Caelan Lochran's 7 or 8 might majority of them might have been penalties
as well,
from what
yeah.
I can see.
Yep. And then with, if you look at the Port of Down side, then we've conceded 71 in 35 games, averaging at 2.06, mm-hmm. I think it is, per game. And then scoring 42 in 35, averaging 1.2 per game. I don't know what that means, but it I think it means that we're going to win.
Yeah, well, I'll go with that. I'll go with that result as well.
I don't know if that helps you, but get your predictions down in the comments section, and we can see how right or how wrong you are after the game. We'll go for it all quick. Oh, actually, we'll talk about the news during the week. Then you want to?
Yeah, some brilliant news that we've been crying out for, and it's going to be brilliant here on Tuesday week, where we'll have fans back.
Yep.
It's been a long time coming. It's something that we have sorely missed all season here. So Tuesday week, the 25th of May, home to Dungannon Swifts. We welcome fans back to Shamrock. Cannot wait. Yeah. I think it's going to be the same arrangements as it was prior to the restrictions that came at Christmas time. So I think we have a total of 438 is the COVID safe capacity here for Shamrock. So all the arrangements will work the same way as it did for the games early on in the season, where the members of the early bird scheme that signed up for that will, I think, they get their email. I think the plan is for them to receive their email to purchase a ticket for the game on Wednesday the 19th of May.
Yep.
Then they have to Sunday at 8 o'clock in the evening to follow through and complete their purchase. And then any tickets that are left over after that will then go on general sale.
Yep.
And those will all be made available through the ticketing section of the Portadown website. But yep. I would recommend to stay tuned to our social media channels on Twitter and Facebook, and also the club website, as more details will be put on there whenever everything is yep. fully confirmed.
Absolutely. Like, it's been a hard time without fans here. I mean, maybe at the start of it, when the fans weren't allowed to go and we were here streaming the game and stuff, you didn't notice it for our first couple of games because you were that busy trying to set up a stream. But see, ever since, especially the big games where Glenavon came here,
yeah,
it just didn't feel, it's not the same. To be honest, it's rubbish. it's like watching training games. I know the players are putting their effort in and stuff, mm-hmm. and they notice the difference, but are still putting, they're still playing the same. But as a spectator, as watching the game, it takes a whole lot away from what Irish League football is, and I personally can't wait. I know it's the last game of the season, the home game anyway, and there's maybe not a whole lot riding on it. There's not a big it's not life or death football wise, but it's just going to be great just to have people about and enjoying it and talking and shouting at the ref and cheering boys on. It's just going to be great to have people back in the place.
Yeah, like it really, like you said, it hasn't been the same all season. We have been in that, we've been lucky that we've been able to come because we do this. But you know, it really hit home to me that night here against Lorne, Lee Bonus's last minute winner against Lorne. You imagine, we spoke about it at the time, how this place would have been absolutely rocking with that last minute winner.
Yep.
And you know, as brilliant as it was that night, it was just missing the fans. It just wasn't as great of an atmosphere as it could have been. So it's brilliant news. It's long time coming, and I personally can't wait.
Yeah, if you, for the early bird scheme members, if you make sure to check your emails this and Wednesday evening. Make sure you check your junk box as well, because sometimes emails go into there and you miss it. But you should be getting your email with your link and your password to buy your tickets, and then if there's any remaining tickets then on Sunday night, they'll be released to the public. So keep tuned to all our socials, keep tuned to your emails and stuff, and we can't wait to get you back in here somewhere.
And just before I go, just on the subject of supporters, Eden Red Supporters Club, they are currently selling Euro Predictor tickets for a competition regarding predicting the scores of the European Championships coming up. So they have asked if supporters want to get involved in that. If you keep a lookout on Eden Red Supporters Club's social media channels, they are on Facebook and Twitter as well, to purchase a ticket for that in regards to their supporters club funds.
Yeah, it's always good for the supporters club to raise money, because at the end of the day, it all comes back into the parent club at the end of the day, and it's a really good initiative as well to get something going, because there hasn't been a whole lot of fundraising with not a whole lot going on supporters wise. So it's good. I've done mine. I don't know how you guess them. I just guessed 2-1 to the home side or whatever it is. But here it's good to have something of interest, especially with not a whole lot going on. But stay with us. We're going to try to get Matthew Tipton. I think he's down in his office, so we'll try to get him up here for a chat with Johnny. And if you can take this wee break, go on to 247.tv/NAPrem and purchase your stream for the day's game. It's going to be myself and ex-Portadown and ex-Carrick coach, actually, Andy Hunter here. on co-commentary. So it's going to be really good to hear from him. He's always open and honest, and he'll give you a really good assessment of the game. So definitely purchase your link on this wee break, and we'll be back in a few minutes.
Hello and welcome back to Matchday Live ahead of today's Danske Bank Premiership game here against Carrick Rangers at Shamrock Park. I'm joined as always here by Portadown manager Matthew Tipton. How are you, Matthew?
Hi, thanks Johnny, you all right?
Not too bad. Now, Matthew, two changes to today's team.
Yeah.
We have Sam Ward and Stephen Taggart in replace of Eamon Scannell and Ben Gay.
Yeah. I couldn't even remember that. I didn't think there was two changes. Obviously, it was a long time, 10, 11 days, which is a lifetime this season.
Yes, exactly.
Both Sam and Stephen had niggles for the Glenavon game, and they were both left out. Mm. So to bring them back in, look, we're trying to play a certain style of football, and we think them two are best suited in a midfield three to do that. Stephen obviously has energy to break forward as well, but we think Sam can get his foot on the ball and play for us today alongside George. So it'll be interesting to see how they cope. You know, I'm glad that it's raining because the pitch is looking lovely. Obviously, I know we're facing it, and the people that are watching can't see it, but there's plenty of grass in it. But at this stage here, the grass tends to grow thick, so it needs wetting. I've asked for a sprinkler system. That was part of my agreement for the new deal, but we haven't got it just yet. So it'll be interesting to see how the boys get on today with the movement of the ball. Mm-hmm.
Last time out, obviously we're coming off the back, even it seems like a lifetime ago, that defeat to Glenavon. Yep. You'll obviously be looking at a response to that today.
It's not so much we're looking for a response today because it's gone. I can't do anything about that game. What our challenge today is to overtake Warren Point. the 3 points ahead of us. They were beaten last night. Now we've got to try and overtake them with three games to go and finish the season as strong as we can. And we want to finish in ninth place.
Mm-hmm. Talking about lifetime ago, like this season, you say it seems to be Saturday, Tuesday since Christmas. So when you have a week's break or a week and a half's break, it does seem like a lifetime. Coming off, congratulate you on signing a new 5-year deal with the club. Yep. You must be delighted.
Yeah, look, it's everything the club said to me, what they want to do and how they want to move forward matches my ambition. So there was never a doubt that I was going to sign it. It was just a case of what could we do? How are we going to move the club forward to make sure everything aligns? There's no point in me wanting to go one way and everybody else going another. Everything's matched up to what I think and how we can move the club forward. And it was just a pleasure to get it over the line last week.
While we're talking about the club and things like that, Lee Bonus and George back today after spending the week at Burnley. Do you want to tell us a wee bit about that?
Yeah, the Burnley were over. They asked her to come over. They'd had some reports and things, and they came over to watch us playing against Carrick last time, actually, here. And after the game, I got a call in the evening to say reports had went in on George and Lee, as well as Jacob, actually, in goal. And would there be a possibility of getting them in? And I said I didn't know at that stage because I didn't know how the season was going to pan out. Obviously, with a bit of luck, they wouldn't have been able to go because we would have still been in the Irish Cup. But then when we got beat in the Irish Cup, they got straight back on the phone and asked could they get them in straight after the Glenavon game. Two of them went over. Like you said, they had a week. Lee just over a week. George came home a little bit before. They're not going to sign either of the two boys, but you know that the work that they've done to get themselves into a position to at least be thought about by a Premier League club is a credit to the two of them, and hopefully it'll stand them in good stead. And hopefully today we'll see a performance that shows that. Because they've trained, you know, with Premier League footballers for a week. Whilst the other boys probably got a chance to put the feet up, they trained every day. So we'll look at that and we'll assess it. I don't think they look tired. Lee didn't train Thursday, but George did, and he looked really sharp. So hopefully that continues tonight.
That's brilliant. Well, Matthew, I'm going to let you go and get ready for the game. And we're going to take a brief break here, and then we'll be back with more Match Day Live.
Welcome back to the Master Live here at Shamrock Park. We heard from Matthew Tipton there again, so interested sort of talking about Burnley and stuff and how the guys got on and then the team selection today.
Yeah, he was making the point there, you know, as he spoke about Lee and George over at Burnley during the week there. I think he said George came home a wee bit earlier than Lee, but he says, you know, both were on the go. He said, I don't think Lee trained with ourselves this week, but George did. And he said George looked really sharp, so he's excited and hope. Yeah. You know, they spent a week training with Premier League players, yeah. So he hopes maybe that's reflected in their performance here today.
And it's really just rewards, especially for Lee Bonus. He's really he's tore up this league, especially the latter half of the year. Really, he's really came on his own. He's scoring regular.
Yeah, for somebody that 2 years ago was playing Mid Ulster football, for what he's done in his debut season and for his hometown club, you know, it's a stuff of dreams for a Portadown supporter.
Yeah.
He's had a great season and also been nominated for Ulster Footballer Young Player of the Year Award. Is a great achievement as well in his debut season.
That's true.
So he's had a magnificent season.
Right, let's talk about today's game then. Carrick Rangers at home here, team that we've sort of struggled against, but then again last time we have that monkey off our back, we got the 2-0 win. Who's going to be the difference maker? I know who you're going to say. You're going to say Lee Bonus and Keelan Loughran. Two players not allowed to mention, no. So mention somebody else.
I am going to go for Adam Sally today, and I am going to go for Michael Smith. I think those are the two players on either side. I think Adam, you know, he's had a very stop-start season. He's maybe scored six or seven goals, but he's missed chunks of the season through injury, and it took him a while to catch up to speed with the Premiership. He scored some brilliant goals. You know, we look at the goal against up at Coleraine and the goal here against Dungannon and stuff. And, you know, I think it's, you know, Adam's getting to that stage now this season where he's all the attributes to be the perfect partner for Lee up front. Yep. He hasn't always shown it. But I think, you know, we're coming to the end of the season now. So, you know, I would like to see Adam really nail down that partnership with Lee, Matthew something to tip about or think about over the summer. So that's who I'm going for, is my main poor down man, Adam Sally.
Well, Maverick and Matt Wright here is telling us to wrap it up, so we're almost at kickoff hour to get ready for the stream. So if you get on the 247.tv /NAPRM, it's going to be myself on commentary along with Export and Carrick coach Andy Hunter, so it's going to be interesting to chat your way through the game. I'm hoping for a good solid Portadown win and comfortable. I would love comfortable.
Comfortable Portadown win, I think, is what we're all after.
Perfect. Well, listen, thanks for tuning in live here, and for other people watching back on it as well. So come on the porch, and we're looking forward to seeing you here on the 25th of May, but all being well here, it'll be a good win for Portadown. Thank you.